your theme song. Leo Wilk, our real estate expert, taking a look at what is happening with real estate in and around Metro Vancouver. And you wanted to come on today and kind of go through the basics of the terms that you may see on a contract when you're navigating a sale or purchase. So let's talk about the contract itself, basic format of what you should be seeing, buying or selling, when you start looking at the document.
Exactly. So the minute you're making an offer, this goes for buyer and seller because it's all going to be the terms you're dealing with. Price is number one, closing dates, terms, subjects, deposit, things like that. And the subjects are kind of the subjects and conditions are one of the most important aspects of the contract.
Okay, so let's dissect some of these that you're mentioning, because items on the contract: completion date, possession date, adjustment date. Yep. What are you seeing on average for these types of dates and closing, and what can work against you when you're putting these dates in the contract?
Well, so if you're competing and the seller wants specific dates and you can't give them to that seller, that might work against you. But typically the completion date is when the money gets transferred and the title gets transferred. After the completion date, you're going to have, you can either get the keys the next day, which is possession and adjustment date. But what we've been seeing lately is, you know, completion on like a Wednesday or Thursday and getting the keys on like a Sunday. So what you've done is you've allowed the seller to get their money, probably use that money to their next home. They can move out on the Saturday, you move in on the Sunday, and it's a very smooth transition that way.
And if you're the buyer, what's a reasonable amount of time to put on that completion date?
You know, we're seeing, if it's a vacant home, I've seen 2 weeks. If it's an occupied home, usually we give it about 2 months, but depends on the situation of each person as well. But let's say on average 2 months, something like that.
2 months on average. Yeah. You mentioned the deposit as well.
Yeah.
What is a respectable percentage that you're putting down so the seller can take that buyer seriously?
Yeah, 5% is the standard, but really you can put down anything you want. If you don't have, some people don't have 5% of $1 million just sitting around all the time. So sometimes we'll have to structure that differently as well, saying we're going to give you X now, some more later. But typically if you've got the 5%, they should be pretty happy on the seller's end.
What do you find is something common that gets overlooked by buyers and sellers when it comes to this process?
You know, for buyers, I would say, you know, especially in stratas or something like that, reading all the documentation, there's a lot of it that you're going to get. So really, sometimes they might read it, but not all of it, and I don't really know. We read them and we report, but our issue is our tolerance could be different, or our risk tolerance could be different. So I always say you've got to read it. I'm going to read it too. That's another reason why inspectors are very important. They sometimes help with the documents in a strat as well, and for houses, inspectors are crucial.
See, this is a good point, because when I've been in the position of actually buying places, some of these strata documents go back 2-3 years, so it is a lot of due diligence to go through and look for items. But what are some of the keys that stand out that could be warning signs if you're looking to buy a property?
Well, first thing you want to do is age of the property as far as stratas go. Again, with the house, you've got the inspector going in. He's going to do his thing. We're going to make sure there was an oil tank scan done. We're going to look at the title of the property, and there's a document called the property disclosure statement. So those are the three key things for the house. But when it comes to stratas, read the AGMs. You're going to really know how the building's standing once you read the annual general meeting that they meet every year and talk about, because that's where they list off what did we fix this year, what do we have to fix, things like that. And then we talked about depreciation reports earlier too. It's depreciation reports are also going to be in there, and it's a 500-page document you get to read in a week if you want to.
And in the depreciation report, what is the key? 500 pages? Who's got time to go through all that?
The key for the depreciation report, again, an inspector will read that as well and report back to you, which is very helpful, or my inspector will anyways. You read what's been done in the building. There's an executive summary typically, and then what you want to go find out is when are all the upcoming costs? When are the major costs coming up? And they'll usually have a graph that says something like, in year 2025, there's going to be X amount for the roof. So what you're able to do is, those dates aren't set in stone. It's not going to happen for sure that year, but at least you can start planning for it. And then you want to look at the strat and say, okay, do they have money saved for this in the CRF, the contingency reserve fund? That becomes an important factor as well, to know how much money they got, are they going to have enough by here? And in that depreciation report, it's going to break down if you're on pace for it or not. And if not, you're going to know that maybe your strata fees are going to go up, or every year you're going to give them, sometimes they do like a special levy once a year, which is, here's $1,500 that just goes into our building savings, right? So it's just like a home. When you've got a house and you got to do your roof, consider that a special assessment, because when you're in a condo and you got to do your roof, everyone's paying for it. We're in a house, you're the only guy paying for it.
Okay, we only have a few seconds left, but subjects, buyers and sellers, what should we look at for subjects?
So subjects, usually it's about a 7 to 10 day process. So subjects, inspection, financing, a lot of deals are falling through because of financing these days with all the changes, and just subject to reviewing the documents, things like that. And what that does is, it, as a buyer, it locks you in the property for 7 days, and after those 7 days, you can decide if you're going to go through with it or not. And as a seller, your deal is almost there, so no one else can buy your home unless that buyer walks away from it at the end of the 7 days.
Okay.
Yeah.
Real Estate 101. Leo Wilk, realestate.com. Find the website for more of the resources. Thanks for coming by.
Thank you.
Okay, we'll take a break. We'll talk bike lanes. I know you're passionate about bike lanes. Canby Bridge, what's in store? We'll get an update on the construction with Greg Harper.